In this new episode of the Internet of Things show, we have Addy from the Windows 10 IoT team that is coming to tell us a bit about what Windows 10 IoT is about and also what's coming in 2019 for you guys in order to learn more about the product, also try it out and so forth. Hi everyone, this is the Internet of Things show. I'm Olivier, your host. Today we have Addy on the show. He is here to talk to us about Windows 10 IoT and what's coming in this product for 2019. Addy, thanks a lot for joining the show.
My pleasure.
So before we jump into the topic, can you tell us a bit about yourself?
Yeah. So, hi Olivier. So I'm Adi Hariharan. I lead the Windows IoT marketing team. Mm-hmm. So my focus is to make sure that we tell great stories about Windows IoT and talk about all the great innovation that's coming in the product.
So before talking about the innovations, it'd be interesting to see why you guys are doing that. Why is Microsoft building an OS for devices?
Yep.
And so what are the trends you're seeing the industry like going towards? What are the customers saying? What do they need from your perspective of, you know, Windows building an OS for these devices?
Yeah, we are hearing a lot of things from our customers, Olivier. So one of the things that we're hearing a lot from our customers is basically they have great devices that's helping them improve the way they do things, bringing in efficiency, bringing in cost efficiencies. The other thing that they're also seeing is that, you know, with the investments that they have, they're also gathering a lot of data from the environment. But they're not doing a lot with that data. And so they want to be able to tap into that rich resource that they have. And so they want to be able to analyze that data and then also make that data a little more actionable. But trying to do that is not easy, right? I mean, IoT projects are really complex and it takes a lot of investments. And once you have a project and you fully try and test it out, try to scale it across, you know, the entire world is going to be quite challenging. And that's where the investments that we put in both Azure and Windows comes into play.
So you were saying that these IoT projects are complex, and actually I'm seeing lots of customers were not coming from the device development world, right? They come from the enterprise, mobile, cloud development, but they want to have to do IoT for driving that digital transformation you were alluded to. And basically, they don't have this knowledge about creating a device and developing for a device. So is Windows 10 IoT actually making their life easier in that sense?
Yeah, so a lot of our customers come to us and ask us, how do I get started? And so we really want to help them. One of the things, Olivier, that we want our customers to be fully aware of is that we've been in the embedded and the IoT business for the last two decades. So what that means is that we've been helping our customers help with their improvements and automation for the things that they do. So with that, we bring in a lot of expertise and we make the platform really robust. Think about the peripheral support, think about the driver support that we have developed over a period of time that comes fully integrated into the product. So to get started on an IoT project, you're going to start with a product that's done much of the heavy lifting, and what they really need to focus on is the customization that goes on top of the product, if you will.
Like their value add, basically, right?
It's their value add.
What about security? Because like security is a big concern, we hear about it all the time in IoT. What does Windows 10 IoT bring in terms of security to these solutions?
Yeah, so Windows IoT, at the base level, brings in all the security goodness that Windows carries. Now, Windows is available in about 2 billion devices. What that means is that we've been learning a lot about security and a lot about the threats that are out there. And we have managed to take that goodness that we've learned through the Windows installation or the Windows install base and brought that down to Windows IoT. So Windows IoT inherently adopts a lot of the security baselines that we bring through Windows. So that's number one. And then we focus on specific security aspects like device health attestation that we bring into Windows to make sure that the device as well as the connection to the cloud is extremely secure.
Nice. Last but not least, or actually might not be last, but last thing, but maintaining devices in the field is something that can be a nightmare. You need to maintain version of the hardware, of the OS, and so on. You need to eventually build your own infrastructure if it's non-existing. Windows has been out as an enterprise and consumer product for some time. Microsoft knows how to do management of an OS, right? So is it the same for Windows 10 IoT?
It is slightly different. If you think about how a customer would have to manage a device today in an embedded scenario, if they want to provide a device update, they would send a technician to the field with a USB stick and then run the updates physically on the device.
Yeah.
We have a better way of doing that.
Yeah. That right? would not be manageable at the IoT scale. Was like
especially when you think about scale.
Lots
it,
of devices.
It is going to be challenging.
Yeah.
So what we have an upcoming very soon is actually also available is the Windows IoT Core Services. Mm-hmm. So think of this as a infrastructure service that we provide to our customers where they will be able to throttle and fully control the updates that A, the operating system needs, mm-hmm. any driver mm-hmm. updates that need mm-hmm. That they need for the peripherals, or any updates that they need for apps running on the device. And this can be delivered over the air so that they don't need to physically send somebody over to the device. They can seamlessly update it from wherever they are, any part of the world.
Awesome. So you guys tailor a nice OS for devices. You add these like embedded specific features to lock the system down. You offer tools to maintain all of that. But you guys are hard at work. There's tons of things coming in 2019.
Yep.
Can you give us a sneak peek? And how can people learn more about what's coming?
Yeah. So we have two flavors of Windows IoT. So we have Windows IoT Enterprise. Think of Windows IoT Enterprise as a full-fledged operating system for a full-powered device.
Okay.
And we also have Windows IoT Core. Windows IoT Core is for a small footprint device. Mm-hmm. Now, the exciting thing that's coming up is that we've already announced support for NXP chip, mm-hmm. and we are going to announce GA for IMX 6, 7, and 8.
Okay.
That is really exciting.
So
because
more and more hardware.
A lot of silicon options.
Makes sense. Yep.
So IoT Core would run on an ARM-based chip with NXP support, Qualcomm support. So now you can think about, you know, really bring down the footprint of the operating system. So that's number one. We also announced support for the robot operating system on Windows, which is really exciting.
Yep.
And the third thing that's really exciting for us is the work that we're doing on Windows ML and making sure that we can integrate Azure IoT Edge into Windows.
Yep.
So that's inherently out of the box, where you don't have to put in additional development mm-hmm. to bring Azure IoT Edge onto Windows.
And bring in the intelligence of the cloud down at the edge, like for addressing scenarios where you have like need for having low latencies or disconnected scenarios, or you have privacy concerns about the data as well, right? So
that's
these
right.
are the kind of scenarios you can implement easily.
That is right.
Okay. So we have coming like tons of events you guys will be at.
Yep.
There's also a series of webinars. So can you tell us a little bit, like 2 seconds about the webinars?
We are really excited about all the innovation that's coming mm-hmm. in Windows. And I am going to be really excited to come back to this audience and talk about all the innovation that's coming.
Welcome to the show.
So we will have a bunch of webinar series. Mm-hmm. So it'll be myself, along with a lot of our developers and engineers will come and talk about the innovation that's coming.
Okay.
And you'll also find us at a lot of events. Mm-hmm. We're excited about Embedded World, where we're going to like make big announcements about Windows IoT, and we'll follow it up with the IoT in Action series across the world.
Yeah.
And we're hoping that you will be able to come attend and also learn about Windows IoT and hopefully also be able to adopt and try it out too.
Yeah. Well, actually, adopt and try it out today. We have resources where we have pointers for people to learn more about Windows 10 IoT, the Azure services that you can run on Windows 10 IoT devices. You can get started with a Raspberry Pi. Like, everyone has a Raspberry Pi on their desk, don't they?
Right.
Or something like that,
right? I do.
We do. We're geeks, I guess. And but actually, by the way, someone for marketing has a Raspberry Pi on their desk.
Say something about how we work at Microsoft.
Exactly, right?
Right.
Just wanted to mention that. And so these links will be added to the description of this show. Addy, thanks a lot for that introduction. Windows 10 IoT, you actually definitely got us excited about what's coming. You guys can meet Addy and the team during the events, on the webinars. Subscribe to the IoT show to learn more about what's coming next, and hope to see you soon. Bye.